A very warm welcome to each and every one of you. My name is Vineet and we are here to attend the final class of Java Comprehensive Course, that is Java Class 8, okay, which is on database and JDBC connections. Now, can any one of you tell me what is the use of database? Why do we use database? Please write down on the chat window. Irfan says store, info, retrieve it. Okay. Amit says organized form of data to store various data. Okay. Mayank says to store logical data and retrieve it when required. Amol says store and retrieve info. Absolutely. Yes. To make a storage of data and whenever required, we can just retrieve the data from the database and use it in our application. Now, moving on. Database is a collection of data in an organized way so that we can update, modify data present in the database easily, okay? You can update it, you can modify it, you can insert rows, you can delete rows, and everything can be done in your database, and you can manage your data very easily. Data storage in database is permanent, okay? That means once the data is stored, it will be remaining there unless and until you delete it. Now, for example, Oracle Database, MySQL, MS Access, DB2, Sybase, these are all different kinds of database that are available. Moving on, how to store data in database? Data will store in tables in database in the form of records, okay? That is rows. One by one you keep on adding the rows into the database that are called records. Each row is one record in the database. Table is a collection of relational data in 2D form, that is in the form of rows and columns, okay? So your table, Hardik says, can't hear you clearly. What about the rest of you? Are you facing the same problem? Please write down on the chat window if you're facing the same problem. Am I audible to you, everyone? Please write down on the chat. Okay. Mayank says video is also good. Yes, audible, voice is clear. Okay, that's very good. Just give me a minute then. Okay then.
Okay then.
So I hope it is clear.
So I hope it is clear.
I hope my voice is clear.
I hope my voice is clear now, Hardik.
Please let me know.
Please let me know on the chat.
And now is it fine? By mistake, I just left my laptop on unmute. Is it fine now? Okay, very good then. So I was on database stored in tables in database in the form of records. Table is a collection of relational data in 2D, that is in the form of rows and columns. Okay, so it is stored in row dimensional rows and columns. Each row is actually a record in the table. Okay, moving on. So that means first you create a database and within that you create multiple tables so that you can store your different kinds of data. Okay, moving on. We come to what is SQL. Okay, that is SQL, SQL. It is pronounced as SQL. So SQL is structured query language. It is a language used to access and modify the data stored in database. Okay, so how to insert a value into the database from your program, or how to query the database, that means how to get the desired result from the database, that is how to retrieve data from the database, how to update a data, how to delete a data. All of these things are done using the SQL queries, that is structured query language. It is used statements to access the database. SQL statements can be divided into two types, DDL and DML. Can any one of you give me the full form of DDL and DML? If you have done database programming before, if you have dealt with database before, you can easily give me the full form of DDL. Amit says data dictionary language. Okay, Amit says DML is data definition language. sorry, data manipulation language. Hardik says data definition language. That's correct. Okay, so DDL is data definition language, not data dictionary language. Amol says data definition language and data manipulation language. Exactly correct. Yes, Mayank, you are also right, and Hardik, you are also right. So we have the full forms. So first of all, DDL, that is data definition language. These statements are used for creation and deletion of database. Like the commands present in DDL are create, alter, and drop. Okay, create is to create a new table or a new database, or alter is used to alter the contents of a table. Okay, what is the use of drop? Whenever you want to drop the entire table, whenever you want to delete the entire table, you will be using this drop command. Okay, so this is the DDL data definition language commands. Now first, the usage of create. The command is used to create table or database. Okay, so you write create, you write the database keyword, then you write the name of the database. Like you want to create a database Vineet, then you'll be writing create database Vineet. When you have to create a table, then you'll write create table, you'll give the table name, and within that you'll give the parameters. One will be, now when you're writing column 1 and column 2, so this column 1 will be the name of the column first, and this will be the data type that will be stored. It could be number, it could be varchar or anything like that. Okay, the data types that are supported by database. Now second column, if you want to add third column, just put a comma after this and then add column 3, and then the data type, that is what kind of values will that column store. Are you clear till here? That is create and create table. So first of all, I'll show you now the database that we'll be using. How many of you have used MS Access? Has anyone used it before? Hardik says yeah, done it. Okay. Mayank says no. Hardik says I. Amit says MySQL used. Okay. So we'll be using MS Access today. So I'll just right click new Microsoft Office Access 2007 database. So let's name it data. Okay, this is the name of our file. Okay, we'll rename it then DB data. Okay, this is our database. We'll just open it. So now when you open it, you'll get a security warning. Okay, just go to options and select enable this content, because if you want to query the database, if you want to make changes into the database using query, you'll have to enable this content. So never forget to do it. Click on OK. After that, now we go to create, we go to query design. Okay, don't forget, go to create, go to query design. Just close this one right here first. Now after closing, you'll find SQL. Click on that, you'll get this command prompt where you'll be entering your queries. Okay, so I have my queries. Let's see. I'll directly copy and use them. Okay. So I'll write create table. Okay, I'm creating a table into it. Create table. I'll give table name tab underscore name. Okay. After that, I open up the parenthesis. Within that, first I'll mention the name of the column 1, that is col 1. Okay, I'll give the data type like number for integer values. That means I'll go put a comma. After that, I'll mention col 2, and then I'll mention that in that you need varchar. Okay, that means it will take character values. Within that, I'll give the size. That means the size will be 10, it will take characters up to 10. And finally I put a semicolon. So this query I'm using to search screen, and your voice is not matching. Is everyone facing the same problem? Instead of number, can we use int? Mayank says no, number will be used in database. Amol says yeah. Are you facing the same problem, that is screen and voice is not in synchronized? Oh, my poor connection is spoiling this today, so I'm just able to see with break voice.
Okay. Mayank says for decimal can we use float? No, you'll be using varchar itself. Okay. Okay, then let's execute. How to execute? Click on run and it will create a table name, that is tab underscore name. And when you click this, you'll find column 1 and column 2. Okay. So I'll go slow and try to sync the voice as well as the video. So let me know whenever it is fine. So I'll go with that page itself. So all of you, are you clear how to use a create command? Please write down on the chat window if yes. Yogesh says yes. What about the rest of you? Hardik says yes. Irfan says yes. Mayank says how to start. Please repeat once. Okay, sir, after query design, where did you click? Pratik says show again. Okay, just a minute. Okay then. And I have a question from Hardik, that is difference between varchar and varchar 2. Now they both are used to take the character inputs, but varchar 2 is used for larger inputs, okay? Varchar is for smaller inputs. I hope it is clear to you. So what I did, are you clear? I just created a file in my E drive, right click MS Access project, that is new Microsoft Office Access 2007 database, okay? So I clicked on that. As soon as I clicked, this is the file that I created. I opened it up. When you open, there will be a security warning. Just enable that security warning. I'll just close this database first. Okay, I've closed this database. When I open it again, I receive a security warning right here. Can you all see it? Please let me know if you can see it. Okay, very good then. Now when I click on options, I need to enable this content, okay? When I click on options, click on enable this content and after that click on OK. When you click on OK, you go back. Now you can insert, update anything using the queries. Now when you have to create a table, first go to create option, the tab on the top, create. After going there, go to the right and you'll find query design. Okay, so click on query design. When you click on query design, you'll find this show table, so click on close first. When you close it, after that, here on the left hand side, you'll find SQL. Okay, click on SQL, you'll come here, you'll see the window where you can write your queries. So query for creating the table is create table, okay, tab underscore name to the name of the table after that, R1. After that, open the parenthesis and close it as well. Within that, give the names of the columns of your database. Okay, so I'll name it tab 1, which is of number type. Tab 2 is of varchar type. Okay, give the size also, anything like that. And 10, and I close it. Finally, at the end of the query, I'll put semicolon. Okay. So in the end, I place the semicolon. Now, if you want to run the code, just go here on the left side again. You'll find a run command. Click on that. As soon as you click on run, here you okay, on the left side, you can see tab underscore name 1. This one. This is your table that was created. So I just open this table. I'll find tab 1 and tab 2 as the column names. Are you clear now how to use it, how to create a table? Please write down on the chat window, everyone. Yogesh says okay, what about the rest of you? Mayank says yes, very clear. Pratik says yes. Hardik says yeah. Yogesh says okay. Amit says yes, sir, so good. Amul says okay. Okay then, let's get back to the presentation. A lot of files has been opened today. Okay, I come to alter command. Okay, this command is used to rename a table or column name of an existing table. Okay, whenever you have to rename a table name, you'll be using this alter command. Now, It can also be used to modify, add, or drop a column field present in an existing table. Okay, so you can modify the table using Alt command. You can add a table, drop, or anything. Now you have seen how to actually query a database using your Access. Okay, so this is the query, that is Alter Table. You give the name of the table. After that, you click on Rename, and then you give that new table name to rename the table. Okay, so I'll show you one more example. So I go to create again. On the top, I go to query design. I clicked on that. Now I click close on the button. As soon as you close, now we go to SQL. I click on that. Now my query is alter. I have to give the table name, the previous one. Let's say tab underscore name. Okay, I want to just rename this, so I'll write rename, and then I'll give the new name, that is tab underscore name 2. Okay, I want to name it to 2, and I put a semicolon. After I've written my query, I click on run. Okay, sorry, alter table is the entire syntax, I forgot, mistake. Now alter table, give the name of the table, rename, and then the table name. Click on run after that. Let's try it once again. Let's try to make it capital, alter table tab underscore name, rename tab underscore name 2. I click on run once again. Okay, there's a problem with that. Let me check. Okay, there must be some issue. I don't know why it is not working right now. Actually, it should. Okay, then let's get back to move. Let's move forward. We'll just come back to alter as well. Don't you worry. Okay, in today's class itself, we'll see it again. Now, similarly, alter table, table name, rename column. Whenever you have to rename the column of a table, you'll be using rename column keyword and then to the new column name. Okay. So we'll be discussing alter in a while. Let's move on. Now when you have to add a column name, use a add keyword after that. When you need to modify, Wang says use table name 1, rename table name 2. Actually that is for tab name 1. Now this time tab name 1 to 2. Okay, I run this code once again. Even it will show you the same thing. Why? What is happening? Tab name 1 is the second table. Tab underscore name is the first table. So it does not matter whatever table name you present. Okay? So we'll just come back here. Don't you worry. Tab name 1 was actually the name of this one. First of all, the one I used. Tab name. Okay, it should be working now. But let us see afterwards. So opening the presentation, now we come to drop. This command is used to remove an object. Okay, that is a value. We cannot get the table, we cannot get the table or values in it once the table is dropped. Okay, that means that table has been deleted. That is quite easy. Drop table and then you mention the drop table name. Okay, so what I do, drop table, and then you mention the table name like tab underscore name, tab underscore name, and I put a semicolon, and go to create, query design, close, then after that go to SQL. Now I'll write drop table, and then you give your table name, that is tab underscore name, that is on the left hand side, the table name, I put a semicolon, I run it. Okay, so my table has been dropped, my table has been deleted. Alfie, are you clear with the drop keyword? That is drop command. Please write down on the chat window if yes. Okay then, Mayank says yes. What about the rest of you? Is everyone clear with it? Everyone, I need you to write down on the chat window. It would be good. Okay then. Now we come to data manipulation. For each and every query, we need to open new tab. Yes, Yogesh, you'll have to go like that. And if I write here, so after that, I can run it from here as well. Let me try to delete the second table as well. So I run. Database, you cannot lock table because it is already in use by another person in process. Okay, it is opened up, or else when you have query, right? You have got your query, just directly run from your query itself. On whichever query you are, you do not have to do it again and again. I was just putting the query like this, so hence it was asking you to save it. Are you clear, Yogesh? Amit says, thanks for making it easy to understand. You're welcome. Hardik says, let's try this for alter. Alter table name, table name, rename to. Okay, that, I guess that's fine. You're telling right. Let's try. I guess I missed two. Alter table, and then I'll mention a table name, that is tab underscore name one. I'll write rename to, and then I'll name it to tab underscore re. Okay, and I put a semicolon. I put this as exactly correct. Let's run it. Invalid SQL statement accepted, delete, insert procedure, select, update. Okay, I'm sorry, it is double L. No, it is giving the same error. Okay. Yes, Mayank, I changed that, I just rectified it, but still. It is ALTER now. Mayank and Hardik. Okay. We'll come back to it. Don't be worried. I'll give you the solution how to use the alter command. Okay? Okay, yeah, that's right. We need to close it. Let's run this once again. This one. Okay? Even then it will give you a error, run, syntax error. Okay? So we'll come back to, instead of wasting time on alter itself, let's move forward. We'll come back to alter once again. Now we were on data manipulation language. These statements are used for managing the data in database. Okay. The commands present in DMLR, it's a mistake. That is insert, update, delete, and select. These are the four commands using which you'll be actually managing the data into your database. That is insert, update, insert for inserting new rows. Update is for updating the values, delete is for deleting a row, and select is for selecting a row or the entire table. Okay, so we'll discuss each one of them one by one. So I move forward, I come to insert first of all. Okay, the insert command is used to enter the records into the table. Records are the rows that are getting added to the table. Now insert into table underscore name. You write values underscore the name of the column in quotes and the value in quotes. If it is a string type or a character, you'll be mentioning it within the single quotes. If you're putting a number into the table, in that case, you do not have to mention the quotes. Okay? Are you clear till here how to insert the values into table? Please write down on the chat window if yes. All of you, can you all hear my voice? Hardik says yes. Pranav says yes. Okay. I guess my voice is coming late to you guys. That is why you're replying late. Is that the case? Mayank says no. Hardik says no. So that means you are replying late. The voice is fine. Amol says yes, sir. Mayank says had a heavy lunch. Okay. Okay then. So I'll create a new query. So I'll write insert into I'll give the table name, that is tab underscore name one, okay, values. I'll open the bracket parenthesis, within that I'll place, let me see what are the values. Tab underscore name one, it takes number and varchar, okay. So one will be number, that is let's say 24 it is taking, and comma, then varchar will be hello, okay. Let's see hello, and I put a semicolon in the end, okay. So this is the way I'm putting a value. Hardik sends me a smiley, says a bit lazy. Now I'll run this code by going to design. I click on run. Now you are about to append one rows. Once you click yes, you can't use the undo command. So I click on yes, and when I come to table underscore name, now when I refresh it, I receive the value 24 and hello. Are you clear how to insert values into the table? Please write down on the chat window, are you clear with the queries and the table? Okay, very good then. Getting back, I come to update. Now update, this is a command used to update the values of a record or column of a table. We use condition to know where the updation is to be done, okay. So whenever you have to update it, you'll have to mention where the update has to be done. So you can use the update command, mention the place where the update has to happen. It will go there and update the values. Now update table set, then you mention the column name in which the update has to be done, and you pass the values. You'll write where clause. Now this is the where clause, okay, to mention where exactly the update has to be done. So where some column underscore name is equal to value of some column, okay. So you have to pass the value, that is if the value is equals to this in this column, then in that case you'll have to change the values, okay. You have to update the values. So let's see whether I have a update one directly or not. If yes, okay, we will not mention table name in which table we are updating, Amit says. Okay, I'll just show you once again. So table, yes, you have to mention it. Yes, Amit, you have to mention it. This table is actually the table name, okay. Now I'll just show you the example. Just a minute. I'll just create a new query for you. Okay, SQL. Now I'll write the update command. So I'll write update first. Then I'll mention my table name, that is tab underscore name one. Then I'll set the value set. Let me just check what are the columns present. Tab 1 and tab 2, okay. I'll write tab 1 and... okay. So I'll set the values at tab 1 equals to 45, where tab 1 value should be 24 at this position. After that, I go to design, I run this code, and I click yes, okay. Now this time when I go to table 1 again, I refresh the values, I'll find 45 instead of 24 that was previously present. Are you clear now? Everyone, are you clear how to use update command? So you mention the column name, first table name, in that a column name, and in that column wherever it finds a value equals 24, it will just change the value to 45, okay. So everyone, are you clear with this? Please write down on the chat window. Each and every one of you, it would be good if you just send me yeses so that I can move forward to the next one. I'll show you the query if you want to see it. Update table name set tab 1 equals 45, where tab 1 is 24. So if you want to see few more examples, you can also enter your values like this. So I'll make 45, L, 45, blue. Like this, I'll keep on adding. And let's say one is 54. No. Okay. Now I go to my, I'll just save it. Now I'll go to query. I'll make few changes like where the value is equals to 45 now. I'll make the second one to 45. Here I'll change it to 1. Okay. Their value should be equals to 1. Now I run this query once again. Design. I click on run. I click on yes. Now when I come back to table, you'll find that all the values that were equals to 45 have been changed to 1. Okay. So everyone, are you clear with this part update? I'm sure you would have been. Amit sends me a smiley. Okay then, we are done with update. Similarly, we'll be using a delete command. This command is used to delete the records, one or many, from a table by specifying some condition where to delete the record. So you write delete from table name where column name equals to value. That means you mention the column name, and that column name, wherever the value matches, it will delete that value. Okay. So in this query itself, I'll write delete table name, that is tab underscore name 1, where column name is tab 1 equals to 1. I put a semicolon. Now I'll just go to design. I click on run. Machine says, sir, I'm back, was disconnected due to network problem. Don't worry, machine, you'll receive the recording. Oh, yeah, delete from, exactly. Delete from table name where tab equals to 1. Thanks, Amit. Now I click on run. Okay, when I click on run, you are about to delete 3 rows from the specified table. I click on yes. When I come back to my table, I'll find all the 3 rows deleted. Okay? So when I refresh it, it goes off. Are you all clear with the delete query as well? Please write down on the chat window if yes. Everyone, please, I request everyone to write down on the chat window. Amit says, please show the query window. This is the query window, you can see it. Okay, Mayank says yes, Irfan says yes, Amit says please, okay. Mohsin says it is just like SQL query. Yes, Mohsin, these are SQL queries. Hardik says yes. Pratik says yes. Yogesh sends me a smiley. Amit says yes. Very good then. If you'll keep on saying yes, I'll keep on taking your names. Okay? So, Amit, I hope it is fine with you now. Let's get back to the presentation now. We are done with delete. Now, what is select? So, select command is used to retrieve the records from the table. Select column 1. Column 2, that means you can mention the column names from table, okay? So only values of those columns will be retrieved. Now, if you want to retrieve all the records, each and every column, each and every data from the table name, so you have to mention select start from table name itself and it will fetch the entire data. So if you want to do it, I'll just write select star from tab underscore name 1, which is our table name. I put a semicolon after that. I go to design. I go to run. Okay, so it fetches the entire query 5 fetches the entire table. Okay, 54 and number. Mayank says if we delete a column, yeah, that is, we are not actually deleting a column, Mayank. What is happening if the query is present? Okay, the query is not present. What we were doing, we are actually deleting a row with the help of column. If in that column there is a number that is equals to 45, then what it will do, it will delete that entire row. Are you getting my point? With the help of column values, we are deleting the entire row. Wherever in the column it will find a particular value, it will delete all those many rows. Are you clear? Please write down on the chat window. I'm waiting for your reply, Mayank. Amit says, we are backing up the old values we deleted. No, they are deleted permanently. That is why it is always showing you a message that is, it is going to be changed now. And it says, can we delete a particular value present in the row? Okay, you cannot actually delete a particular value present in a row. You can update that value. Okay, so why to delete it? You can update it. Are you getting my point? Bank says okay. Amit says, please tell again the function of select. Select is used to select values. Okay, as the name suggests, that select actually selects a value. You can select the values of a particular column, or if you want to select the entire thing, then in that case, you'll be simply writing. I'll just make a query for you. That is select star from. Okay, Mohsin says, what is the difference between alter and update? Okay, I'll come to your point, Mohsin. Query SQL. Now I'll write select star. That means star means the all the records from table name is tab underscore name one. I put a semicolon. So it will fetch the entire values of that table Amit. Okay. Now run it. So all those values were this itself. Now if I change it to more, I'll add few more values. Okay, these are enough. I'll just save it. I go to my query itself. Create query design. Close SQL. So again I'll mention select star from tab underscore name one. Okay, I put a semicolon again. Now if I run this, I receive all those values. Okay, so Amit, are you clear with it? And Mohsin says, what is the difference between alter and update? The difference between alter is that alter is to change the name of a table, or the whenever you have to add another column, the entire column to it. For that, those cases you'll be using alter command. Update command is to update the values in a table. Okay, are you clear with it, Mohsin? Okay, very good then. So getting back, okay, before going to integrity constraints, now to all of you, those who have attended the entire class from the starting till now, so tell me, what are the commands that we have learned till now and we have used till now? Please write down on the chat window. Okay, Mayank says insert, update. Irfan says update, create, alter, insert. Mayank says drop. Amul says delete, select, update. Mayank says create. Mayank says alter. Ahmed, create, update, insert, delete, select. Irfan says delete. Yogesh says create, insert, alter, update, delete. Mayank says delete. Ahmed says drop also. Mohsin says delete. Absolutely, that means you guys remember some of the commands. That's very good. So now we come to integrity constraints. Not null, whenever you have to mention that value cannot be null. Unique, whether the value, if the values that you are entering should not, should be unique in that particular column. Okay, it should not be repeated. In that case you'll be using unique. Primary key will be the, that will also be unique by default, and you'll be using that key to actually find the values in your table. Okay, so since they will be unique, you can use that as a primary key. Foreign key. Foreign key is present in our table, like there is a primary key in your table and it is the same in the other table as well. It is the primary key column. That, in that case, that will be actually the foreign key in that table. Okay? And check. So let's discuss them one by one. First of all, I come to not null. It is a constraint that ensures that every row is filled with some value for the column which has been specified as not null. So you'll be directly using the values that whenever you create all those commands that you have learned till now, in that you'll be using it directly. So when you create table name, you just have to mention data type, and after that you have to mention not null. That means this column cannot be null. You have to mention the values whenever you use it. Okay, so this is not null. Moving on, we come to unique. It is a constraint used for column of a table, so that rows of the column should be unique. It allows null values also, okay, but only one time it will take it. The value should be unique, okay, it cannot be repeated. Now create table, table underscore name, whenever column name, you write unique after that. That means this column will be unique, it will take only unique values. Primary key, it is a constraint used for a column of a table so that you can identify a row in a table, okay, uniquely. That means you can just pass the primary key and you know that in that column you won't find any other primary key with the same value. So that is why you can use it to reference your table. Mayank says just like we have asterisk sign on web pages, we can't leave it not null concept. Absolutely, absolutely Mayank. That's correct. Okay, so when you have to mention a column as primary key, in that case you write primary key after the column name. You mention the data type and the column name. So this is for primary key. We come to foreign key. It is a constraint used to establish a relationship. Amit says primary key means unique value. So what is the difference between unique and primary key? Okay, that's a good question, Amit. Primary key is unique and null simultaneously, but if you talk about, unique and not null, and if you talk about the unique key, in that case, it is only unique, but it can take null values as well. Okay, are you clear, Amit? Please write down on the chat window if yes. Okay then, very good. So we were on foreign key. It is a constraint used to establish a relationship between two columns in the same or different tables. Okay. Now for a column to be defined as foreign key, it should be defined as a primary key in the table which is referencing. Okay. One or more columns can be defined as foreign key. The constraint identifies any column referencing the primary key another table. Okay, that means you have a primary key in one table, and if you find all those values in the second table as well, then that column in the second table is actually the foreign key of the first table. Okay, so that column in the second table is actually the foreign key, right? For foreign key also you'll be mentioning like this, like you mentioned the primary key, it will be the foreign key. So let's say table underscore name one, this was the table, so this is the primary key, this column is the primary key of this table. Now in the second table when you use it, if you use the same column there itself, then that same column can be mentioned as foreign key, okay, because it is the primary key of create table. So all of you, are you clear till here? Amit says yes. What about the rest of you? Everyone write down on the chat window if you are clear with the constraints that are available in it. Mayank says okay. Amit says please repeat. Pratik says yes. Pranav says yes. Yogesh says yes, clear. Now Amit, what I was saying, you have a primary key column, you have a primary key in table 1. Similarly, you have the same column 1, that is in table 1 you have column 1 as primary key, so you have the same column 1 in the table 2 as well. So in table 2 column 1 will be named as foreign key. Okay, the one which is primary key in table 1 will be named as foreign key in table 2. Are you clear now? Okay then. Hardik says yes, Amit says yes. Now SQL clauses, we have already dealt with select, from, where and update. These are the SQL clauses. We'll understand order by, group by and having one by one. Okay, we'll run the code as well. So first of all I come to order by. This clause is used by the values of a column in ascending or descending order. Whenever you have to sort the values, you fetch a value, okay, and you have to sort those values in descending or ascending order, you can use this order by clause. So select, you put the EMP name that is from EMP1. Okay, now EMP1, you must be wondering what it is. Yes, I'll just tell you, Amit. EMP name means table name. It is actually the column name, not the table name. And EMP1 is the table name. Okay, so that is what you are writing. Select column name from table name. And then order by column name. And you mention DESC for descending and ASC for ascending values. Okay. So let's see it. Order by, okay, I have the commands from order by, so I'll just copy them directly. Okay, now actually I have a previously prepared database. Now I'll open that database. Now this one, I have few tables, that is EMP1, EMP2, and I've got a table student. Okay, so similarly I'll go to create, I'll go to query design, I click on close, and I come to SQL. Okay, within that I'll paste my query. The query is select EMP ID, EMP name from EMP1. So EMP1 is this table that is right in front of you. In that I'm selecting EMP ID and EMP name. Okay, it will select that and it will order it by EMP name, that is the name present. Okay, by this column. When I execute this query, I go to design, I click on run. As you can see, I receive only EMP ID and EMP name. All the names and employer IDs are fetched and they have been arranged in the ascending order, that is ABC, DEF, FGH, HIF, and R. Okay. Now I make another query. By default, it always sends you an ascending value. Okay. It orders it in ascending way. SQL. Within that, you can write it in the same line as well, Amit. It is up to you. It does not matter whether you write it in the next line or the same line. Now, after this, I'll mention DESC. That is for descending. And I click on run. Okay, as soon as I run, you can see this time the result is different. First time it was starting A, D, F, H, R, R. This time we have the results from R, R, H, F, D, A. So all of you, are you clear with the order by clause and the ascending and descending one? Amit says yes sir, Mayak says yes, Mohsin says yes. What about the rest of you guys? Show me some energy everyone. Once we are done with these three clause, we'll have a break. Okay? So till that time, show me some energy so that we can have a break after that. Okay, Amol says yes, Mohsin says yeah, Adik says yeah. Mayank says no questions for today. Today we are learning, okay? Mayank, we need to learn the database. So maybe after this I'll have some questions. Okay? Amit says so many queries, haha, so confusion. Mayank sends me a smiley. Okay? Now actually today was database, this is something new, okay? You will be learning it, you'll be seeing it for the first time, very new. So that is why we'll just create, we'll run these things and you'll understand it. Hardik says, is class for 3 hours today? Why? Did you receive the time from 4 to 7? No, then why do you think it is for 3 hours? Sir, there is no next class, Amit says. Yeah, this will be the final class, but I'll arrange a test for each and every one of you. Hardik says, because of break. Break won't be of 1 hour, Hardik. It would be around 5 minutes. Okay then, without wasting any more time, let's move forward. I come to the group by. This clause is used to collect data across multiple records and group results by one or more columns. So you write select department from student. Student is the table name, department is the column name. Okay, you write select column name from table name, where have you put a condition now, that is subject 1 should be greater than 20. Okay, this is another column that is subject one, in which we are checking greater than 20, and we are mentioning that group by department itself. So you'll understand when we'll see the results. So student, we open it. In student, you find department, student ID, student name, and subject 2. So our query was, I'll just get the query. So remember this, department and student 2. I come to query. I have to create a new one, create, query design, close. I go to SQL, I paste my query. Now query is select department from student. Now student is our table name, database name, the table name. In that table name I've got department as one column, so select department from student, where subject 1 is greater than 20. Now I'll just figure out, subject 1 should be greater than 20. Subject 1. Okay, instead of 1 it will be 2. Subject 2 should be greater than 20 and group by department. So we'll just figure out 2. 1 is greater, 2 is greater, 3, 4 and 5. We should receive 5 results like that. Okay, so I come to query. Now I go to design and I run the code. When I run it, civil, CAC and MEC, and we only receive the department values because we do group by. Okay, so when we come here, mechanical, one disqualified, civil, CAC, then again civil and then again CAC. That is why in result we only received CAC, because these were repeating, civil and mechanical. Civil were 2 times, it will only give you 1 time, and mechanical only 1 time. Okay, triple E did not qualify, so it was not there. So result is civil, CSC and MEC. All of you, are you clear with it? Everyone? Please write down on the chat window. Manx is okay. Amit says, yes sir. What about the rest of you guys? Be quick, write down on the chat window. Hardik says, query page. Okay, query, I'll have to write it once again. It won't go back. Okay, so I'll just create a query for you. Create, query design. Close, SQL, and this is the query. The table is 2. Okay, Yogesh says, Hardik, are you done with the query? Please write down on the chat window if yes. Okay, Yogesh wants to see the original table, so this is your original table. We are checking for marks greater than 20, and whenever it is so, it will just group by department. So it will find CSC 2 times, civil 2 times and MEC 1 times, but in result it will only show 1. Amit says, where it is used in practical. This is one practical thing. Whenever you have to compare, you have to find whose marks is less about an application in which you find the marks. So you want to differentiate using the marks. So you have to find out whose marks is greater than 20. So you'll be finding names, right? So different subjects, all the subjects, so name could be repeated, but it checks the marks for different subjects, right? So whenever it is greater than such particular condition like 20, it will fetch all the names right there and you get the names of those students directly. Okay? So I hope it is clear to everyone now. I come to presentation once again, and I have to having clause. Okay, this clause is used in combination with SQL group by clause. Okay, within using the group by as well, it is used to filter the records that a SQL group by returns. So select max subject 1. In our table it is actually subject 2 from student. Okay, we select the subject 2, we write max group by. You write department, having minimum, you mention subject 2 greater than 20, okay? So it is used with group by. Now I'll make another query. Here itself I'll change it. Having clause, copy it. Come here and I paste it. Okay, I'll change this to 2. And I change this one with 2. I save the file. Or I run it, go to design and I click on run. Okay, the query is select max
subject to from sub student group by department having subject to greater than 20. When I run it, this time I get 30, 49 and 22. And if I see the student table, 30, 49 and 22. So 30 is for civil because in civil one received 25 and one received 30. So it is gives the maximum value. Mechanical there was only 122, and in CSC out of the two you get 49 because this is the maximum value. So all of you, are you clear with that? 30, 49 and 22, why we are receiving this value. Please write down on the chat window, each and every one of you. Guys, I'm waiting for your answer. Amit Sinha says, query window, I'll have to create one more again. SQL paste, this is your query. Everyone see it? Mayank says clear. What about Pratik, Hartik and Amol? Just understand all these queries. This is how you'll be accessing your database. After that, I'll show you the connection. That is an interesting thing. Okay? So just don't get bored with this, because you'll be using in your application, you'll be using database. And since this is the easiest one to handle, okay, you'll find it real easy to use this database. That is why I'm telling you in MS Access. Hence, and moreover, it won't take much memory in your computer. Okay then, I hope it is clear to you. So getting back, and I come to basic functions. These basic functions are also available in SQL, so we'll be going through them once. So all of you, what about a 5 minutes break? Do you want it? Please write down on the chat window if yes. Mayank says yes, Hardik says no, and even I say yes. Amol says yes sir. Mayank says break. What about Pratik and Yogesh, don't you want a break? Hardik says lol. Pratik and Yogesh, do you want a break? Okay then, we'll have a 5 minutes break and then we'll come back and start with these basic functions. Okay, we'll see examples and then we'll move on to the interesting part, that will be the JDBC ODBC connection. Okay, until that time you have a task. All of you find out what is your system. Is it a 64-bit system or a 32-bit system? Okay. Hello everyone, are you guys back? Please let me know on the chat window if you're back. I guess few people have came back with the, they've just joined the class again. Okay, good. Amit, that is just for adding the table name. Okay, what about altering the table name? If there is a present table, I have to change the name of the table, then how to change it? Name of a column, then how to change it? You are actually adding a column to the table. Okay. I had a sound nap of 5 minutes, Mayank says. Okay, very good then. Amit says modify. Okay, you want to put modify in between. You want to put like alter table, table name, modify, column name, and then again the data type. Okay, let's try it if you want it. Okay, I go to, let's try with employee one only. Okay, there's a table name that is employee name. I'll change it to employee name one. Create SQL design, add, sorry, not add, close. Create query design, close, SQL, alter table, table name is EMP1, table name is EMP name, okay? So EMP name, and then I'll write modify as Amit says, modify, and then column name and data type. Okay, first the table name, alter table name, EMP1 is the table name, and EMP name is the column name. EMP name one. Is that fine? Amit? Hardik says video hanged. Amit, is that the case? Amit says yes, sir. Amit says video hanged. Okay, I'll just try to rotate it. Okay, just a minute. Can you see the video now? Is it fine now? Okay, very good. So I've written alter table, table name, modify, column name to this. Okay? Let's copy this also if you want. So I'm running this code now. I go to design, I click on run. Syntax error, all table statement, okay? So it is on a syntax error. And as far as I just saw in this break that we took, alt is not supported by MS Access. It is supported by all other database. It is not supported by MS Access. Okay. So we'll just write one more thing for the final time for alt table. Let's see. So alter table, the name of the table name EMP1, that is the table name. Then again I'll write alter column. Then I mention the column name, that is EMP name. Okay, what we have done, we have changed the ID. ID is right now in EMP is actually of number, okay? Now we are changing into character type. Amit says, that does not matter, Amit. Alter in table in capital and modify in table. Either you can mention all the letters in capital or you can mention them all in small. Okay? Both will work. I'm trying to change the data type of EMP ID to character. Let's see. I go to design and I run it. The database engine could not lock table EMP1 because it is already in use. Okay. I'll just close this table now. I come to my query again and I go to design, I run this and not me log, I think one more place it is opened. I'll just copy this query and I'll close all. Okay, so I now create a new query design, close SQL, I'll paste my query and let's run it now again. Now as you can see, it has been converted into text, okay? Mayank says, roses are red, skies are blue, strings are immutable, wrappers are two. Okay, very good. Mayank says, for the last two classes, I missed all my poems. Yes, you did. So all of you, that it has been converted. Alt actually does not work with, is not working with each and everything, but you can change the data type like this. So there are many ways. Just just hit and try. Most of the things will work with alter as well. Okay. So I've shown you one example that is working. So I'll just get back to presentation. Now we were on count, to count the number of records satisfy condition, okay? Maximum, to find the maximum, we have already used a maximum in one statement. Find the maximum value of a column of all the records present in table. Minimum, to find the minimum value of a column of all the records present in table. Average, to find the average of a value of a column of all the records present in the table. Sum is to find the sum of all the values of a column in a table. And finally, the distinct, to find the distinct records of a table. Okay? So I'll just open up my... So I'll use one. Let's use count itself, okay? All the other functions are used like this itself, count. I'll be sending you this file as well so that you can directly use the commands, okay? You can see it to see the examples, okay? Distinct means unique, distinct. Okay, there's one piece, distinct things. Are you clear? Okay, so create, query design, close, SQL, and paste. Select count from students, so I'll just see how many people, how many entries are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So query 2 should give me a result that is 6. So I'll just go to design, I'll click on run now. Okay, so I click on run and I receive a value 6 right here. Can you see? Okay. So you can use all these functions one by one to get the result, desired result from the database. So everyone, are you clear with these functions that are available? You have all your functions present in this file. I'll be sending you all this file. Minimum will get the minimum one. Maximum will get the maximum one. Average will give you the average. Okay, some marks from students to get the sum. Amit sends me a smiley. What about the rest of you guys? Please write down on the chat window if yes. Okay, Mayank says yes. Irfan says yes. Now we come to joins. Okay, there are different kinds of joins available. Join is used to retrieve data from two or more database tables. Okay, you could have many tables in your database. Now what happens if you want to data from two tables, okay, on a basis of a condition, then you'll be actually joining that table. So that is called joins. Now joins are of four types. One is cross join. This join returns the combination of each row of the first table with every column of the second table. That is a cross join. That is, you receive the results from both the tables, like from the first table as well and from the second table as well. What is inner join? This join will return the rows from both the tables when it satisfies the given condition. Okay? It will give the entire rows that are present in both the tables. That is an inner join.
left, now there are outer join as well. Outer join are of two types. One is left outer join and the right outer join. Suppose if we have two tables, one on the left and the other on the right side, when the left outer join is applied on these two tables, it returns all records of the left side of the table, even if no matching rows are found in the right side table. Okay? Sound down again. Is that so, everyone? Is my sound low? Please write down on the chat window if yes. Amit says no. Irfan says yes. Hardik says yeah. Yogesh says not low. Mayank says low but clear. Okay, I'll try to speak loudly now. I hope it will be fine now. Now, as I said, left outer join gives you the result from the left table. Right outer join will give you a result of the right table. It is the converse of left outer join. It returns all the rows of the right side table even if number matching rows are found in the left. No matching rows are found in the left side table. Okay? So we'll see the example of one. Let's say right outer join itself. I'll just copy this. I come here, I'll create a query, create, query design, close, SQL, and I'll paste it. So, select emp1.empid. In the table emp1, there is a column that is empid. So, you write select emp1.empid, emp2.department. Okay, it is comparing it with department 1 and emp1 id is this. After that, from emp1, that is from emp1 right outer join emp2 on emp1 id should be equal to emp2 id. Okay, we are comparing the ids of both the tables. First table is emp1, second table is emp2, and we'll get the values, that is emp1 id and emp2 department, okay, in the result. So let's find out the ids which are equal. Emp1, we have 1, 2, 1, 2, 4, 6, and 5. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. Okay. And EMP2, I have 1, 2, 3, 4. So we should receive a result 1, 2, 3, 4. But remember, in EMP1, we have 1, 2 times. That means we should receive a result 5. 5 results as total. Okay. So I'll just come to query 3, and I'll just run this code. Okay. I go to design. I click on run. Okay, there's an issue. There's a space, I guess. Let's run it once again. Okay, I have stripe mismatch. EMPID, EMP1, EMPID, EMP2.department from EMPID, EMP1. Okay, now what is the type mismatch? Can you tell me? Can anyone of you tell me why it is giving me a type mismatch? Database not matching, Amit says. Actually, we altered it. If you remember, we used the alter command and we changed the type to from, that is number type, to string type, that is text. Yes, Amit, that's exactly correct. So I go to view, design view. As you can see, department text, student name, ID number, student ID, EMP ID, we are testing for EMP ID. View, design view, EMP ID, as it is text, so I'll select number. Okay, so I'll control S, query 3, again let's run it. Design, and I click on run. Team already opened. Okay, we'll close this EMP, close, save, and close EMP2, sorry, query 3, and I run it once again. Go to run. This time it runs and I receive the result 1, 1, 2, this and 4. Okay, and I received all the values of department right here. So employee ID and department, that was present in the query. All of you are clear with it? Please write down on the chat window. Amit sends me a smiley. Mayank says yes. Amol says yes. What about the rest of you, everyone? Write down on the chat. Yogesh says yes. Okay then. Irfan says yes. Very good. So you can imply all the other joins as well. We'll be sending you the queries. You can use that. You'll just see my screen. Okay, Amol, for that just right now we won't be covering this SQL part, okay? You can just send a, you can post it on community itself. That will be the best place. We'll be discussing this there, okay? Is that fine, Amol? Are you joined in the community? Absolutely nothing is, even if I do not know, I'll just figure it out. I'll find it out. Don't you worry about that. You can just post it and that is my responsibility how to find the solution for you. Okay? Okay then. Just post it on go there itself. Now I come to JDBC. Okay? Now we are on some interesting thing. That is JDBC, how to make a connection. So all of you, I told you that you find out whether your system is a 32 bit or 64 bit, all of you just find it out. Okay, now I come to first of all JDBC, that is Java Database Connectivity. Mine says 64 bit. So JDBC is an API that helps us to connect our Java program to the database and do the manipulation of the data through Java program. Right now what we were doing, we made a database into the MS Access and there itself we are running the query and making changes to the database. What if we want to make changes to the database using our Java program or application? How to do that? So you need a connection with the database from your Java file, that is the JDBC connection. Okay, so program to the database and to do the manipulation of the data through Java program. I hope you have understood the use of database connectivity. Moving on, how to write a program in JDBC. That is how to write in your Java file, but before that we have to make a connection. All of you pay attention right now and see. Okay, we'll be following each and every step. I hope you have got Eclipse with you installed, each and every one of you. So first of all, tell me everyone on the chat window whether your system is a 64 bit or a 32 bit. Amit sends me a sad smiley. Don't you worry, Amit, you can just install it. Irfan says 32. Mayank says 64, Amit says 32, Yogesh says 64, Amol says 32. Okay, now my system is a 64-bit system. JDBC ODBC drivers, everyone listen to me, JDBC ODBC drivers are only for 32 bits. Okay, then how to make a connection? For 64-bit there are no JDBC drivers. So does that mean we cannot make a connection in 64-bit? That's wrong answer. Yes, we can make it. Okay. So first thing, what I'll do, I'll go to command prompt. Okay. I want to open, because you cannot directly open your JDBC through control panel, JDBC ODBC connection. So this is the command that I'm writing right now. Okay, so I'll just send it on your chat windows. All of you open your command prompts and run this. Not all of you actually, just for the systems with 64 bit. Okay, this command is for you. Just use this command and run it only for 64 bit users. For 32 bit, I'll just show you, give me a minute.
Can you all hear my voice, everyone? Okay, how to paste it? You can directly copy it from here. That is from your chat window. Okay, I guess you missed some part, everyone. So you have to go the command prompt first of all. Those of you whose system is 64-bit, you have to use this command that is on your chat window. After that, go to your command prompt, right click on that and click on paste. Okay, when you click on paste, after that press enter, then it will open this window that is ODBC Data Source Administrator. For 32-bit systems, I'll send you a path. That path has to be pasted right here on the top. So I'll just show you. I'll copy the copy. I click here. I paste the path and press enter. So I'll come on this page. I have to click on data sources, that is ODBC. Okay, when I click on that, it will open the 32-bit system. Well, it is for only 32-bit ODBC drivers. Okay, 64-bit will use the run command prompt and then it will open right here. So everyone, have you done it till now? If you have done it, please write down on the chat window. Mayank says getting error. What is the error, Mayank? Because I have copied the same path, I'm copying it. I come to my command prompt. Okay, I guess I have made some mistake. C Windows system, last error which you have got, same I am getting. Just a minute, Mayank. All of you, the command that I've sent right now, use that command, that will work.
Yeah.
Everyone, 32-bit systems people, are you there till the page? Yogesh, Mayank, with 64-bit system, you will be using the command that I've sent you right now. Just run it. And rest of you, system is 32-bit, have you reached the place that is this ODBC Data Source Administrator? This window, please let me know. Waiting for your replies, guys. Hardik says yeah, Mayank says yeah. What about the rest of you? Mayank says got it. Yogesh says yeah. What about the 32 people? I'll call 32 and 64, right? What about the 32 ones? Are you there? If you want to see once again how it is done, go to Windows, go to Control Panel. After that, click on Administrative Tools. Again, you'll come to Data Sources, that is ODBC. Double click on that and you'll open the same windows. It is for 32-bit systems. Hardik says mine is 32, so Hardik has done it. What about the rest of you? Irfan? Irfan, Pratik Best? Amol? Please let me know if you're there. Then I'll move forward to the next thing. Okay, Amol says yes. Now, once you are there, now you have to create system DSN. Okay? Now, how to do that? Click on add. Now, that my DSN is DSN which I'll be using in my Eclipse. Okay? So, how to do that? Click on add. Everyone click on add. After doing that, when you click on add, you'll come to this page. Here you have to select everyone. Just have a... That is
access driver that is .mdb and accbdb, accdb. So this is the access driver. You have to select this one. Everyone, if you have selected it, click on finish. Let me know as soon as you have done this. After clicking add, you have to select this driver and then click on finish. Hardik says done. What about the rest of you? Are you done? Okay, I'll show it once again. Nothing. When you are on this window, click on add. When you click on add, scroll down a bit and you'll find access driver .mdb accdb. Select that and then click on finish. If you are done, tell me, then I'll also click on finish. Once you click on finish, it will open another window. I click on finish, it opens ODBC Microsoft Access Setup. Everyone, are you on this window? Please tell me. Okay, Amol says, yeah, I'm there. What about the rest of you? Mayank, Irfan, Hardik, Yogesh, Pratik. No, not .mdb, the below one. The one that is below that. .mdb and then .acc, something like that. Mayank, did you get it? Yogesh says, my system is on. Yours is 64-bit. From where did you open it up? I said you opened it up using the command or the path that I've given you. Okay, use the command. It will show again. Let's go back. I click on add. Just have a look this time that I'm showing. Scroll down, you'll find. That is this one, Microsoft Access Driver. And SQL, you're talking about this one that is at the end. So are you seeing it now? Can you find it? Mayank, did you find it? Other one is not there, right here, not this one. The second one you have to select. User DSN, not the user DSN. You have to go to system DSN, okay? Not the user DSN, just remember, are you on system DSN? Okay, you guys has got it. Everyone, are you on system DSN or user DSN? Confirm it. System, very good. On system, click on add and then select your driver once again, that is access driver .mdb accdb. Okay, once you are done, click on finish. Now give me the final confirmation if you are there. Amol has already done it years ago right now. He's actually getting bored, everyone, for him. Yogesh says, yes, I'm there. What about the rest of you? Mayank, Hardik? Are you there? Okay, Hardik says done. What about you, Mayank? Mayank says that file, do you have Microsoft operating system, sorry, MS Office installed on your system? Do you have MS Office? Okay, he does not have a MS Office, then how will you find the driver in it? Okay, so Mayank, just wait and watch right here, and when you get your Microsoft operating system, sorry, MS Office installed in a system, then we'll do that thing. Okay, so just have a close look. After you come here, now you have to select a database. Now you click on select the database, you have already made it. Okay, I had fresh Windows installed yesterday. Okay, that's fine. Now, like you created a database in eDrive, I showed you a database that was that I guess it was db.bd data. Okay, this was the database that we created. So database you create previously, after that you are just connecting the database with the connection. So you come here, since my database was in the E drive, so I click on E volume and I find my database, all the database that are present. I'm selecting data.accdb or data.bd data, any data that I'm selecting, okay? And I click on OK after that. So everyone, are you done? Have you attached your database with your setup? Please let me know. Everyone write on the chat window if you're done till here. Are you guys done till here? Please write down on the chat. Amol says yes. What about the rest of you? Amol is the quickest one right now. What about the rest, guys? Please tell me if you're done. This is one simple step. You have to click on select. Select your database that you create. And just create the database right now. Do not put values or tables within that. Create it and just attach your database on this. Okay, Yogesh says done. What about Prateek, Irfan, Hardik, and Mayank? Have you understood it? Irfan says you are done. Hardik and Prateek. Hardik says done. What about Prateek best? I think he has also done it. After that, give a name to your data source name, okay? Anything. Vineet or your name. Anything you write it. Once you are given the name, click on OK and you'll find that DSN that you created on the window itself on, under the tab that is System DSN. Are you here back on the screen? Okay, Yogesh is done. All of you be quick. This was the simplest task. We have to do something else as well. And for the 64-bit system especially. 30-bit system has got the 32-bit JDK itself. But for 64-bit, you do not have a 32-bit JDK. You'll have to install a 32-bit JDK. Then only you'll be able to run your application, to run your ODBC connection. Everyone, are you here? Have you created it? Please tell me, write down on the chat window if you are done. I'm waiting for your reply, everyone. I hope you are done. You have created your this. So after that, just press OK. Just remember that you created the DSN. I will be using the DSN name itself. I've created one with the DSN name. Okay, I'll close everything now. I'll go to Eclipse. Now in Eclipse, all the 64 system ones, please have a look, and others also for your knowledge, just have a look right here. Mayank, if you can just concentrate right now. So I click on new, create a new project, okay? Something like go to new, Java project, anything, A, B, C, next and finish. After creating the database, now when you go right click on your project, properties, you'll find JRE system, Java SE 1.7. This is actually for 64-bit which I have installed because my system is 64-bit. When you go to computer, when you go to C drive, in your C drive you'll find one folder as program files, one folder as program files cross 86, that is for 32-bit files, okay? So right now I'm using a JRE that is present in my 64-bit, that is this one. Okay, but what I need to do, I need to use a JRE that is an 86 bit, and that this is not already present. If you'll see in your system, you won't find a Java folder in program files cross 86 because you have installed a 64 bit JDK. Okay, so you'll have to install a 32 bit JDK as well in order to make a connection, that is JDBC ODBC connection. So I'll just take the path. I've installed it. Your first step is install your 32 bit JDK. And then I'll take a path to JRE. So this is my path. I'll just copy this path, remember this path, okay? Now I come back here. What I did, I went to my project, I go to properties, in properties, I go to libraries, I find 64 bit, I select the library and I click on remove. I remove this one, okay? So I hope you are clear till now. After removing the libraries, I click on add library. Okay, when I click on add library, I'll come to this page. Hardik says, how can 32 bit be installed in 64 bit PC? Try it and you'll get the answer. Because I'm seeing it, hence it will be. Okay, Hardik? I've done it, everyone can do it. It happens. Because you'll be using a 32 bit JDK. That is why there's a folder that is program files cross 86 for 32 bit installations. Right? Yes, Mayank, backward compatibility of Microsoft. It is present in each and every software that comes. Now, when you come to this page, select JRE System Library. Click on Next. Go to Alternate JRE. After that, right now you can find JRE 32 because I have made it already. I have this 32. So, in your case, you won't find it. So, click on Install JREs. Okay, click on Add. Okay. After clicking on add, select standard VM. I'll go slow. Click on add. After selecting add, click on standard VM. Click on next. When you click on next, first of all, it will give JRE home. So paste the path that is of 32 bit. I pasted it there. Now I'll make it. I'll simply name it J. Anything you can name it. I'm naming it J, which is of 32 bit. Now I'll click on finish. When I click on finish, I can find JRE J as well, so I can select that as well. Okay, so when you have recently made for 32 bit, that is cross 86, select and press OK. When you'll press OK, select J from here itself and click on finish, and you'll find J here and click on OK. Now it is using a JRE that is of 32 bit. Okay, so I have my project. Now you'll find this when you'll face error when you'll be making a database query, or else it will be running fine. So this is the query how to make a connection. So let's go to Eclipse first and go to presentation first, and we'll see what are the things present while you make a connection. So are you clear till now? Those who are using a 64 bit, or whenever you deal with a 64 bit system, how to make how to use a JRE in your Eclipse that is 32 bit. An error I'll show you that if you use a 64 bit, you won't be able to run your database connection. You won't be able to make the connection. Okay, it will give an error. Yogesh says yes, clear. What about the rest of you? Write down on the chat window. Okay, let's say your connection is done. Okay, that means you have created, you are using a 32 bit. Okay, now how to write a program in JDBC? First, register the driver that you actually created, the DSM, connecting to database. After that, finally, create SQL statements in Java, execute SQL statements, retrieve result and close connection. Okay, so this is the program right here, small program that is public class JDBC program. First thing, this is registering the database. So write sun.jdbc.odbc. These are pre-formatted. Okay, you have to use like this itself. So write class for name sun.jdbc.odbc, JDBC.odbc driver, and registering database. This is the registering. Second thing is connecting database. So you write connection, you make a object of connection con driver manager dot get connection. You write JDBC ODBC and I'm writing DSN. The one you created right now with your name or whatever variable name that you gave, you have to write it here itself. DSN is one that I've used. You want to see it?
I go to my command prompt, I'll open the same thing. I go to system DSN. Here I've created one as DSN. So I'm using it right now. Okay. So that is DSN right here, and this is connection. Then how to create in statement. So statement st equal to con dot create statement. Using st, I'll execute my query, that is create table employee ID, that is column name and data type, column name and data type. This is executing statement, and finally I close the statement and close the connection. I hope you are clear till now. These are very simple statements. Everyone write down on the chat window if you are clear with this. Each and every one of you. Adik says clear. Irfan says yes. Yogesh says clear. Okay, very good then. So let's go to Eclipse and we'll try the code, the same code right here. So this table should be created with the name that is employee. In my database, that is this one. Okay, that is database one. From my Java file itself, so I'll go to Eclipse. I'll just run this code. But before that, I'll make the connection change. I'll change the JRE that I'm using. Right now, I'm using a 32-bit. I click on add library, system next. Alternate GRE, I come here and I use GRE 7, that is the latest one, 64-bit. I click on finish. Right now I'll be using the GRE 7, I'll remove this 32-bit. Okay, I click on OK. So GRE 7, no error, it's fine. Now I'll run this code. When I run this code, I receive an exception right here. As you can see, ODBC driver manager, the specified DSN contains an architecture mismatch between the driver and the application. So you cannot directly use it like this. Okay. Now how to use it? I'll use the 32-bit JRE. So right click, I go to properties, Java build path, I'll remove this one first. I go to add library, I go to system library, next, alternate JRE. Okay, I select the alternate JRE and I'll select 32-bit and I click on finish. Right now I'm using 32-bit, okay, this time when I run the code, I receive a result, table created. At the end I'm printing table created, so we are done. And when I come to my database, three tables, I just refresh it. Come here. I refresh it, F5, I find a table that is employee that was present that I created using my Java file. So everyone, are you clear with this? Please write down on the chat window, this was for creating a database table. So I've created a database table successfully. Everyone please write down on the chat window, I'm waiting for your answer. Hardik, Irfan, Mayank, Pratik, Yogesh, Amol. Mayank says yes. Okay. Now I'll insert a value to it using Java, same connection queries. Now when you have to insert the values into database, you'll be using prepared statement. So you'll write prepared statement PS, con prepared statement, insert. Now within that you'll mention the queries. Right now you do not know the queries, hence I'm passing the question marks, and I'll pass the values here, 1 and 1. Okay, and I'll set the string to ABC like this. And PS execute update is executed. Okay, when I run this code, it will inserted statement is executed. When I come here, I open this employee, I find 1 and ABC that I passed using my Eclipse right here, 1, and I second column I change the value to ABC. Okay. Okay, Amol says how to take the input from the user. You can use the scanner, take the input and save it in a variable. After that, you can pass that variable in the database. Okay? Is that fine? Amol, please let me know if it is okay with you. I'm waiting for your reply. Even from the command prompt, you'll be using executing a Java using your command prompt, then also it will be the same scanner files.
Okay. Have you used Notepad for coding in Java before? Have you coded in Notepad and then ran your program in command prompt? Please let me know.
Yes, Mayank says yes, I have. So Mayank, you can understand what I'm trying to say. You give the input in command prompt itself. What about Amol? Have you used it?
Say yes or no, or else Mayank will be there to help you. He'll be posting a document for that. How to run a Java file first, write a notepad. Runtime input by command line input. Amol says yes, he has done it. Okay, that's good. Or else Mayank will post a document, right? Am I right, Mayank? Sure, he says. Okay, then we'll receive a document from Mayank. That will actually illustrate how to run a code on the command prompt. When you have written your Java code in Notepad, then how to run it on the command prompt. Okay? So that's good. Now once I have inserted, now we'll see the updation selection query in the same. So we are fetching the value, so result set is used. Execute query S. S is equal to select star from employee. We know that it will fetch the values from the employee table. And finally it will save in the result set. Result set is in the starting is set to minus 1. So you need to use rs.next. So go to the next one and it will keep on printing. So when I run this code, I receive employee ID as 1 and employee name as ABC because only one value I have inserted till now into the table. If you want to see, it is right here 1 and ABC. So what we are doing, we are actually fetching the values, inserting and fetching the values using the Java code. That is the application. Okay? I'm sure you are understanding something out of it. Finally, updation query. You have already understood all the queries. Update employee, send employee ID, employee name. You are putting question marks because you are not sure about the values right now. You are passing these values right here like set int 1, 2. Second position you are putting the GHJ and at the third one you are passing 1. That is employee ID will be 1, employee name will be GHJ and employee ID again will be 2. Okay? This way, so it will be updated from 1 to 2. When I run this code, update statement is executed. I come here, I refresh it, I receive 2 and GHJ. Are you clear with this, everyone? I receive 2 and GHJ when I refresh it. Please write down on chat window if yes, everyone. Okay, so this was update and finally I'll delete it using the delete query, same as delete from employee, where employee ID question mark, you pass it as ps.set 1 and 1. Okay, one argument, so you are passing 1 for the first question mark. When I run this, delete statement is executed and after that I just use the selection, I'll find nothing in the result. Right click, run as Java application. It should have deleted by now. Okay, there's no one right now because we updated it. So in the deletion query, I'll change the employee ID to 2 here. Okay, I save my file and I run this. Delete statement is executed. Now I come to selection once again. I run this code. This time it is empty because I deleted that value. All of you, are you clear with all these statements that I've used in Java? I'll be sending you this project. Run it and try to understand it. Everyone, are you clear with it? Come on guys, this is the last class, show me some energy. Mayank says yes, Yogesh says yes, only two have understood it. Amol says yes. Irfan says yes. Okay. So, let's get back to the presentation. So insert we have understood, update we have understood, delete we have understood, how to retrieve records we have understood, and finally we are done with today's topics. So all of you, were you able to understand topics that were taken today? Did you receive information from today's class? Did you find it interesting and informative? Please write down on the chat window. Hardik says yeah, I did. What about the rest of you? Amol says no sir, why do you think so? What happened?
Was the class not informative for you? Yogesh says yes. What about Mayank and Infan? And Amol, can you tell me why didn't you find the class informative today? Mayank says school info. See, take more difficult example. Take more difficult example. Now, it was important for you to understand the basic concept first instead of directly using the difficult examples. Are you getting my point, Amol? I cannot take you to the top level first and then come to the base. I'll have to start from the first level and then to the top. Because there are people who haven't seen Eclipse before. There are people who haven't seen the database before, right? So, can you tell me, Amol, were you aware how to do the JDBC connection in a 64-bit system? Amol says take small, Mayank says take small steps to reach to the top. Exactly correct. Amol says no. So, did you learn it today? Did you learn it today? How to do it? The JDBC connection in 64-bit. This is the way that you do it, or else you won't be able to do it. You cannot run your queries through your Java file. Okay? So that means you learned something in this class. You were receiving something in this class. Okay? Okay then. Irfan says, now I know something about JDBC. Amol says, yes, I mean you would have taken project kind of example. Okay then. So Mayank, first of all, I have few queries for you. Okay. I send a project, that is kind of project that was on banking system. Right. On banking system on that Facebook community. Did you submit me the solution first of all? If you would have taken initiative in that, I would have sent you the next example. That is, you can use the database into that banking system. You have understood how to insert values to it. You have understood how to update it, how to retrieve values from it. Okay, you have understood everything. So I have told you each and every steps. Okay, now once you create a banking system, you have understood how to create a banking system. You have the codes. Right now you are saving something, each and everything into an array. Now, next step is you have to use a database for those values. You have to store all the account details, everything into the database, and you have to retrieve those values from the database itself. So that was the next step as a project. Okay? But you haven't attempted the first step itself. Are you getting my point? So that was impossible for me to show you the project itself and show you the database. Are you getting my point? Or else I would have shown you an example on project itself. Amol says, yes, I'll complete the example. Absolutely do that. I'll also post a solution on that. And then the next question would be that you have to implement a database on the banking system. Because I understand, or else you won't be able to use it properly. Amol says, and then go for a project. Exactly correct, Amol. This is the way. Do the first part and then the project with the database. Okay? Mayank says, I'll submit the solution today. Okay, Mayank? Very good. Now, I want to give you information, a very important information, each and every one of you. How many of you know that in Edureka you have an Android course as well? How many of you are aware that you have an Android course in Edureka as well? Mayank says, yes, I know it. Hardik, Irfan, Amol, Yogesh. Amol says, I know. Hardik says, I. What about Irfan? Do you know it? Okay, very good. Yogesh also says, very good. Now, what if I tell you that I have something good for you if you want to take up Android course? First of all, are you interested in Android? Because you all are my students, everyone, each and every one of you. Okay? So, I'll give you something. Mayank says, yes. Hardik says, yeah, very much. Yogesh says, sends me a smiley. What about the others? Yogesh says, I am interested. Irfan and Amol, don't you like Android or are you not interested in Android? Okay, then I'll just reveal the mystery. Now, if you guys are interested, okay, you have already learned Java, you have the concepts of code
programming in Java, right? And as you know, in Android, Java is used, and Android is one of the latest technologies of today. It is on boom, okay? It is the technology of today. That means it is the best one. So for that, if you want to enroll yourself, if you want to learn Android, what you have to do? I'll first tell you steps and then I'll reveal the mystery. So I'll just log out from this account first. Okay, and I'll log in with my Facebook account or any other registered account with which you are registered. I'll go there. I'll click on Android development. Everyone have a close look. I click on Android development. After that, I click on buy now. Now, as you can see, this course is chargeable. It is not a free course, everyone. Now, the cost of the course is 7,999 rupees, and including the service tax, you'll have to pay 8,988. But since you are a student of Java itself, for this very reason, you're receiving a 20% discount coupon. Okay? This will be a 20% discount coupon. For redeeming that, for using that, click on have discount coupon. And the discount code is Android itself. Okay? A-N-D-R-O-I-D, and click on redeem. Once you click on redeem, you'll receive a discount of 1,798 rupees, and you just have to pay 7,190. Okay? So you receive around 2,000 discount on the entire course fee. That is the Fanroid. So guys, if you are interested, go ahead, grab this opportunity, use this discount code, and get yourself enrolled in the Android course. Okay? And I'll just send the discount code to you, and there's a validity for this discount code. It is only valid till 30th of March. You have a batch starting on 31st, as you can see. March 31st, you have got a batch starting. So if you want to enroll yourself in the batch, you can use this discount code directly, and it will be valid till 30th of March midnight. So I'll just send the code. This is the discount code, that is capital A-N-D-R-O-I-D. Okay? Even you can use a later batch. That means every week we have a batch starting. You can use any batch. And if you want a discount, you can use this discount as well, and you can register for future batches. Okay, that will be later. If you cannot enroll right now, you have got that option. Hardik says fees increased. Yes, Hardik, and even it will increase even more. So this is a good chance for you. Even from 7999, it will increase more. So if you have got a good chance in front of you, you are getting a 20% discount as well. So it is high time, or else it will again increase. Why do wait? Okay, you'll get to learn good things. You've already seen the quality that we provide you guys. Are you happy with the Edureka learning and my teaching? Hardik says, yeah, I'm happy. What about the rest of you? How was the experience till now, I'd like to ask? You took a Java course with us. So how was the experience? Hardik says, great. Yogesh says, yes, of course. Yogesh says, happy. Irfan says, it was good. What about Mayank? Anamol? Not very happy? I'm waiting for your answers, guys. You can say whatever you feel. Okay, then he must be writing something. Okay, Mayank says, never had a class online which never felt less than a live class room experience. Very good. Thanks, Mayank. That was a good answer. Okay, then that's very good. So guys, if you are interested in Android, go ahead, grab this opportunity, use the discount code, and get yourself enrolled. Mayank says, great job, keep it up. Absolutely will do, and not without but support. Your support was very good. You are a great audience, each and every one of you. That is why it was possible that we had such a good job. We did such a good job. Okay? So, I'd like to ask, how many of you are interested to enroll yourself in the Android 31st batch using the discount code? Just write on the chat window any answer. I just want to know your interest. Yogesh says, I am. Okay? Mayank says, when is the test for Java? Mayank will inform you through email and the Java community, okay? Still, I haven't fixed the date. I'll do it soon. All of you, apart from Yogesh, how many of you want to enroll yourself in the Android course. Answer could be yes, no, maybe, anything, but give an answer to me. Yes, no, or maybe. Either of the three answers. Hardik says maybe. Okay. Irfan says maybe. Mayank says fix it before 10th April and after that I have my project review. Mayank says I'm interested in Android. So are you coming to the next class, that is 31st batch? Are you enrolling yourself? And what about Amol? Not a word from your end. Hardik says, can you give some details about the certificates? Okay, Mayank says yes, he is interested to come to the next batch, and Yogesh is also quite interested. So I'd expect each and every one of you guys, you already know each and everything of Adireka. Why not? There's nothing to stop you right now. Okay? Now, are there some details about certificates? Certificate will be provided from Adireka itself. Amol says, I've already done the course from Android. Okay, I was not aware about that, Amol. So, we have already one student who has done, even Mahvish has done the course of Android and then came for Java. Now, certificates will be provided from Adireka, and these certificates will be globally accepted and they can be verified from our website as well. Okay? So guys, for today I'll take leave. Bye bye. Take care. Keep connected on the Facebook community. We'll keep on talking. There. Are we getting the certificate for the done Java course? Yes, after the test. According to the marks that you receive, you'll receive a soft copy of the certificate, Hardik. Each and every one of you will receive that. Okay. So guys, be connected on the Facebook community. Baba, take care. Thank you all. It was a great experience till now. And hope to see each and every one of you in the Android course as well. Okay, you'll find me there as well. So we'll meet again. Okay, so bye-bye, take care. And don't forget to fill in the survey for the last time and mention there if you're willing to enroll for the Android course. Advance says, thanks Vineet and Adireka for this. You're welcome, you're most welcome. So bye-bye, take care, thank you.
The organizer has ended the session and this call will be disconnected. Goodbye.